Hi everyone, this is Asma Khalid from Sada Panel, and in today's video we will be learning about using a manual telnet session to test an SMTP connection. Now by default AWS, DigitalOcean, Virtual and many other server providers like that, they block your email, they block your emails outgoing port 25. Now the reason for that is they don't want spam emails to go out of that. Now many users, even our users, they don't understand that the problem is that their outgoing port 25 is blocked, and they think that okay, the email is not going through, so the problem might be on our side. So to check or not whether your emails outgoing port 25 is open or not, you can always conduct a manual telnet session to test the SMTP connection and send out a test email. So in this video we will be learning about what a blocked port 25 looks like, and how an unblocked port 25 looks like, and how you can send out a test email using that unblocked port 25. So without further ado, let's just jump straight to the video. Alright, so first of all, what you guys are going to do is you're going to connect into your host, and after that click on your command console. I'm using Bitwise for this. Okay, so now I need to connect to my SMTP server. Now to connect to my SMTP server, I either can enter the IP address of server BC after telnet command, or I can enter the MX record after the telnet command. If I don't know the IP address of my server PC, I can always go for the MX record. Now to find that MX record, what you can do is you can go for the lookup command equals to MX and then your domain name, and it will give you your MX record. Of course, you can always use Google Dig to get you just enter your domain name and you'll get all of your records, including your MX records. Now, once you're happy with that, you can enter your MX record. But since I already know the IP address of my server PC, I'm going to go for that. Simply write telnet, then the IP address of your server PC. Make sure to enter your port after that. Once you're done with that, click enter. Now what it's doing is it's showing that it's trying to connect, but it will not connect to that server since it doesn't have the permission, the authentication. Now by default, the AWS and many other server providers block the outgoing emails, email port. So that's why it's trying, it's not going to connect. Of course, you can always ask your server provider. You can request them to open up that channel for you guys, and more so often than not, they might reject your request also. So this is how you can see that my outgoing email port is blocked. So now let us see what will happen if my outgoing email port 25 is not blocked. How I can see that, how I can connect to my server, how I can SMTP server, and how I can send out a test email. So let me just simply connect to my server now, to my host first of all. Okay, once it is connected, let me just go into my CMD. Now when I write telnet, and then I also know the IP address of my server PC, so I don't need the MX record over here. And make sure to enter your port. Once it's done, you can see instantaneously it was just trying, and then it is connected to my SMTP server. So now that I'm connected to my SMTP server, I can first of all have to send out a hello email basically. So a hello message actually. So I'm going to write ehlo or hello, and after that my domain name. So it's giving me a number of commands that I can use. Next, I'm going to enter the mail from email and the receipt to email.
So make sure these are capitalized, the commands over here. And of course, you have to make sure that your email addresses are correct. Their spellings are correct. They are in existence. So when I click enter, I'll get a confirmation that yes, your email form is correct. Next, I'm going to give the rcpt2 command. For this, I'm going to use the same email again. Again, it has given me a confirmation that this email is okay. Now we have a mail form email. Now we have a C2 email. Next, we need the body of the message. So first of all, I'm going to give a data over here. This is to alert the SMTP email server that rest of the message is going to be the body of the message. So when I click enter, I can start entering the body of the message. First of all, I'm going to enter my subject. The subject of the message is that test subject. Next, I'm going to enter the body of the message. I can write paragraphs over here, whatever you like. And whenever you write a full stop within the message of the body, you have to write two full stops. Otherwise, it's going to assume that you are finished with your message. So once I'm done, just simply click enter and enter a full stop over here. This full stop on a complete empty line is going to confirm that this is the end of your message and to send out your email. And once I click enter, you'll be able to see that my email is okay. It's been sent. It's in queue. And this is going to be my email ID. So I have successfully tested that, okay, my outgoing port 25 is not blocked. Now I have completed my test. I need to get out of my SMTP server. So it's simple command of quit will get you out of it. So I'm back at my starting point, and this is how you can easily conduct a test on your SMTP server and check whether or not your outgoing port 25 is blocked or not. So that's it for today. If you still have any questions, just drop a comment in the comment section, and don't forget to like and subscribe CyberBanner.